It's 8:30 at night. Is your refrigerator running? Welcome to Whose Refrigerator Is It Anyway? The latest Cerrito Entertainment game show. Of course, we've been playing game shows here every Thursday night during the pandemic, and we've been drinking Riverset Rye as well, our presenting sponsor here every Thursday. I'm your host and your hero, Kevin Cerrito. We're coming to you live all over the internet. Thanks for being here, and you're going to have a chance to win some prizes, and I will tell you about that here in a moment. But first, I'm going to introduce you to our celebrity panel. Up first tonight, we have Master Chef Junior winner Logan joining us. Logan, how are you?
Hello, I'm doing great.
Are you ready? Are ready to find out if this is your refrigerator or not?
That is behind you right
now. Is that your refrigerator? We'll find out.
Is it?
Who knows? Also joining us here on the panel tonight, we've got if you watch our game shows on Thursday, you see the panel game shows, you know this face. She is Memphis's best comedian, 25 years running since she was born. Since the category was invented for the Memphis Flyer, and now here she is back with us today on the panel, Katrina Coleman.
Thanks for saying I'm 25.
And she's also an IT expert. Katrina is here to play the game with us tonight. Also joining us, you can rise and grind with him every morning.
So can your wife.
The most popular Cerrito Entertainment host out there, he is CJ Hurt. What's up, CJ?
What is up? I don't know how much grinding I'm going to be able to do tomorrow. You got me up late. Or I guess
Is it me?
Somebody's got me up late, man.
Yeah. Technical difficulties.
I've got a whole lot of rising and grinding for you, boy, tomorrow.
I'll take full responsibility. We're having some technical difficulties. We are starting a little bit later. It's a little bit past 8:30 for sure. But, hey, we're moving faster than a lot of these states. Also, also joining us on the panel tonight, we have now from 98.1 The Max. You can listen to him every afternoon. He just jumped over from Kix 106. Country Corey is here. What's up, Corey?
Hello. What's up, my fans?
And we are scheduled to be joined by Mary.
Corey.
What is happening? Corey is freezing up,
is
right?
We spent 20 minutes talking to him, and he never froze. He froze now.
He's frozen. Corey might need to jump back in on the link.
I think he's in the freezer. It's freezing out the refrigerator for him.
I see you, Logan. Got the buns going.
I'm trying. I'm working it, you know.
I think we got Corey back. What's happening, Corey?
Hi. I don't know. All of a sudden,
hey.
I told you my internet sucks.
We're gonna try something else interesting here right now. So we've got Corey here on the panel, but also joining us, a Memphis television icon. You can watch her every morning on live at 9. Mary Beth Conley.
Hey, there I am.
Oh, it happened.
I'm 25 years old too, Katrina.
All right, Mary Beth, we got to check your connections on the other computer. Make sure those are muted so we can we won't get the feedback there. So we are live. This is a brand new game show tonight that we are debuting. So bear with us. It is a game show in which you can win a prize, Katrina. Do you know what our grand prize is going to be at the end of the month here?
No.
So the winners tonight, a best team name and the first place team tonight, you'll be entered in a drawing to win Thanksgiving dinner for four from Cash Saver. Cash Saver is giving you everything you need to make your Thanksgiving dinner this year. And that is the prize going today to the winner.
Awesome.
Of the month, not today, but the month. I misspoke there for a minute. So the month. So we will the winner today for best team name and number one overall. You throw it into a hat. We're going to draw because if you are going to stock your refrigerator, you should do so at Cash Saver. So that's our grand prize for the month of November.
Wait, what if you got five kids like Corey?
I don't know, Corey.
Yeah.
You got dinner for four. I mean, what are you going to do with the other three people?
Mary Beth, you're back with us?
I'm going to win it twice. What are you talking about?
All right, good. So we've got Mary Beth. We got a little technical problems getting started again. I apologize. Okay. We're streaming on a bunch of different pages. Wherever you are, we can interact with you now on the chat. So if you are if the chat or the comments, depending on what site you're at. So if you're watching on the Sarita Entertainment Facebook page or the Riverside Rye Facebook page, or if you're watching over on Mary Beth's Facebook page, you might be watching there tonight. Then just jump in on the comments. We should also be on Twitter and Twitch and on SaritaEntertainment.com and YouTube. Yes, shout out to the YouTube folks watching as well. So it's a very fun game. I'm going to explain the rules to you. You can also check the rules out at SaritaEntertainment.com at any point today. So you can watch if you want, but if you want to try to win the prize, you're going to have to submit your answers over on the website. The rules are very, very simple. Just like always, assemble your quarantine. You can play by yourself if you'd like, or you can assemble your quarantine however you want, whether it's Skype, FaceTime, whoever's at your house, whatever you want to do with the CDC, as far as you're complying the best you can with the CDC's recommendations. You want to be safe. Those numbers are going up. Those numbers, Mary Beth, where are the numbers at here for COVID?
That would require me to have paid attention to the news today. So,
Wait, even Mary Beth paid attention to the news.
A fair question.
We're all.
You
out.
Know what? I do know the numbers of COVID patients in the U.S. are fewer than have voted for Biden and Trump together. Okay, that's all I know. Right.
That seems good.
Yay for record turnout.
Yeah, that's right. Yes. Yeah. We're at 1,000 a day. I know that much. We just broke 1,000 a day in the U.S.
It is quite a few. All right, so your quarantine, assemble them however you would like, designate a team captain, and they will submit your forms for your team. So if you're playing by yourself or you're playing as a team, just have one person submit your answers at SaritaEntertainment.com. You'll wagering tonight. We're wagering. Sports betting is legal now in Tennessee, right, CJ? You know about that.
Yes, very much so. What do I know about?
This concerns all of us, CJ.
Oh, man. What do I know about, though, for real?
Wait, Logan, you can't. He can't, right? Yeah.
No, he can. He's 18. He can do that.
Oh. All right.
You just made his day.
Okay, so.
Hey, wait. Logan, did you vote? Was this your first election then?
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Yay. Awesome. Yeah. Congratulations. Shout out to the new voter.
All right, so you'll be wagering tonight in this game, 1 to 4 points, however you feel confident if you know which one of these panelists. Because what you're going to be doing is matching the refrigerators to our panelists tonight. They're about to introduce themselves, give you some fun facts that may or may not help you guess the correct refrigerator. So you'll gain or lose points. So you'll wager. When you wager, you lose or gain those points that you wager. So if you get the question correct, you'll get the amount of points that you wager. If you miss it, you lose it. So you could end up with a negative score. That is a possibility.
In which case, you have to send Kevin Cerrito money.
correct. We have five panelists and four refrigerators, so choose wisely. There's also going to be a wild card item at the end, so there'll be one item that could belong to any one of the panelists, whether or not they had a fridge or not. And so that is the rule. Any questions? Does that all make sense to you, Corey, of how this is working for folks?
Yeah.
Corey?
Sure. Absolutely. Whatever Kevin Cerrito says.
Logan, makes sense to you?
So there's
all right, so you can check those rules at Sarita.
Yeah, you know.
Check the rules, SaritaEntertainment.com or SaritaEntertainment.com. That's where you go to check out the rules. Let's see. But first, I got to tell you, our presenting sponsor is Riverset Rye. I mentioned them at the beginning, crafted right here in Memphis, Tennessee. Riverset Rye is an unfiltered 93 proof small batch straight rye whiskey with a smooth finish. Go against the current and grab a bottle of Riverset Rye today at your neighborhood liquor store if they don't have it. Your neighborhood liquor store, then you need to move.
Just move which spot, huh?
We're all so aggressive lately. We were taking stands.
All right, the form should be activated online, folks. So if you're looking for the forms, they should be up and going on our website, sarinaentertainment.com. And let's get to our very first refrigerator. Here we go. You are guessing which one of the – well, hold on. Before we do that, we do need to go through and give you our false start tonight a couple of times. We got to get some fun facts. We need to – because if you don't, you may be tuning in. There may be one of the two people that, on the panel that you need to know a little bit more about before you guess the refrigerator. So let's start with Logan, our panelist first. Logan, I will tell you something about Logan. He's the only Memphian that I know of to win a reality competition show. We'll see if D'Angelo Williams – is D'Angelo CJ still on Amazing Race?
He is still on Amazing Race. For those who missed it, we had him on with his partner, Cinnamon and Sugar is the team name they want us to call him by. We had him on today. They recapped yesterday's episode, and next Thursday they'll be on again to recap next week's episode. They're still there. Barely. They're holding on, but they're still there.
Well, unless D'Angelo wins, Logan still has that title. It's Memphis's best reality show contestant. Logan, will you give the viewers two facts they may not know about you that may or may not help them guess your refrigerator this evening?
So you may or may not know that I am a chef. And so naturally there's going to be a few things in my refrigerator that, are some special chef touches. But you also have to remember I am still 18, so there are going to be some 18-year-old things in there. So it's going to be tough. I've set it up. And another fact is, I like to do indoor rock climbing. It's my sport of choice. I also like to do kayaking, and I'm pretty active outside. So that may or may not help you.
All right, Master Chef Junior Champion Logan. Those are his facts. Up next, Katrina Coleman, who if you're a regular player here, you're very familiar with Katrina.
I will give you a couple of facts. This is not a fact I'm going to include. I'm a stand-up comic here locally, which is why you probably don't know my name unless you've watched Kevin's show. I will give you the one true fact that I grew up in West Memphis, Arkansas, which may give you some ideas about what my fridge looks like. You're not wrong. I will also tell you, however, that I was prom queen.
Really?
In my high school.
Really? Ooh. Nice. Wow. Big time.
I did not want to be, and in fact, started a petition in order to stop prom queen votes from happening. And in retaliation, my high school class.
But is the original stop the vote?
It was more of a carry situation.
Oh.
I was afraid.
Oh.
It wasn't that. It was nice. It was lovely. I cussed.
You got telekinetic powers?
They didn't pour big blood on you, did they?
I wish.
All right. Up next, we've got CJ. You got two facts that may or may not help people guess your refrigerator?
They absolutely aren't going to help you guess my refrigerator. but I lived in Germany for a while. Father was in the military. So Bremerhaven was the base we were stationed at from, I want to say, 91 to 94. And the first Pokemon that I ever had was a Squirtle. So good luck with that.
That's some CJ shit right there.
CJ, the master of the fun facts for his lower third on the Rise and Grind show. Every day changes, right? CJ,
yeah. You got something different. Every day. Different got fun something fact about every day for him. Today's was, I got two words for you. And if you know, you know.
All right.
That's cool.
Country Corey can be heard now on 98.1 The Max. Corey.
I don't know.
This is like the game you play at school, right? Like, Cage, they say to stand up and say something. Have you ever played that game?
No, I was talking about what CJ said. He said, if you know, you know.
Oh, so that's your first fact is you do not know the two words.
I don't. Fact about me, number one. Taco Bell took Mexican pizza off the list, and that's some BS.
Yes, I support that.
So last night we made homemade Mexican pizzas, and they were better than Taco Bell.
Strong.
Fact number two, I hate cilantro. Absolutely hate it. It's the worst. It tastes like soap and runt socks. And I know Logan's having a culinary right now.
No, that's genetic. It's actually genetic. You either taste delicious cilantro or you taste soap. Like, there's no, you can't overcome it.
I don't hate soap. I wash with it. I just don't eat it.
It just means you're real white. That's all it means.
Probably not going to help you with the food. You just know you're not going to see cilantro.
Oh, man. That narrows it down.
I think all of us have a big old tuft of cilantro just hanging out in the fridge.
Just sticking it in the fridge, just cilantro everywhere.
All right, Mary Beth's turn. Mary Beth, your two facts that may or may not help people guess your refrigerator tonight.
Well, I've already figured out that CJ's refrigerator does not have wiener schnitzel, right? So if there's like a refrigerator with sauerkraut or wiener schnitzel, that's not CJ's.
Correct.
And I want to know how Corey knows what burnt socks taste like.
Yeah. That is a good question.
Oh, that is a good one.
I was bullied in Mississippi.
This is why I'm an iconic Memphis newscaster, because I ask those tough probing questions.
You're the Barbara Walters of the Bluff.
That's
City.
Right. That's right. Without the lisp. So I actually followed the rules. Well, except for that part about actually being able to click the link right and actually get on time and all that. Right. But aside from that, I followed the rules, and my two questions will tell you a lot. I mean, if you know anything about Arbonne, you will be able to tell my refrigerator. So one of my facts is I am an area manager with a company called Arbonne International out of California. And my other fun fact, if you know anything about big families, you'll be able to guess my refrigerator, because I am one of seven children.
All right. There we are. There we have it. So Mary Beth's
big family is something that I am acquainted with.
What?
Big families is something I am acquainted with.
Well, your refrigerator and my refrigerator will probably look similar.
I'm guessing Costco labels.
Perhaps.
Maybe.
And some Dr. Thunder. Dr. Thunder and Costco. That's my guess.
Oh, wait. I didn't specify. My family was also poor, so we could not afford soda.
You had
We lived way out in the country, so I actually grew up drinking powdered milk.
Oh my God, powdered milk was the worst.
And I hate milk.
Put my stuff on cereal when I was a kid. It was terrible.
It's
horrible. Oh, God, a flashback.
Don't even get me started.
Man, these guys are older than me.
Logan will appreciate this, because you know how those boxed mashed potatoes are so, nobody who likes mashed potatoes could ever eat potatoes out of a box. Well, powdered milk is the equivalent of mashed potatoes from a box.
The potato flakes.
It
hasn't changed.
All right, y'all. We got to get to the game.
All right.
We got to get to the game.
Hey, Kevin, cannot help it if my fun facts were more fun than everybody else's. I can't help it.
So when you bring the powdered milk, it's grail. I don't know what to tell you.
They might have been. All right, let's get the fridge number one. So again, if you want to grab your form, if you just joined us during this conversation, SaritaEntertainment.com, you can find the links wherever you're watching.
Yeah, we were calling.
Don't forget, we can't guess yet.
All right, no hints or comments now as we go through the refrigerators and give them an opportunity, the players at home, to look at the fridges and try to guess. Remember, we have five panelists, but only four of them submitted a picture of the refrigerator that will be shown. So only four of the refrigerators will be shown. So one of them will not be shown. Let's get to refrigerator number one. Refrigerator number one. Let's take a look at this refrigerator. We have
that is.
There's not much stuff in there. In the bottom shelf. Not much produce. We've got a pitcher of some sort. And I'm going to go get even bigger in here. Can we? Nope. That's as good as we can get. I'm confused. A very, very junky door selection here. So fridge number one.
Groceries.
Junky?
I'm saying there's nothing in there.
There's large items in the door here. There's large items in the door. I'm just giving my comments, y'all. You will feel free to jump in and defend your or your friend's refrigerator.
Put things in the door that don't need the same level of refrigeration.
Okay, so yeah, maybe it's scientific.
I don't know. This is sounding awful like Mary Beth's refrigerator here, you know?
They've got a picture of sweet pea or great Kool-Aid, so they ain't doing too bad.
No, that's a water filter full of Kool-Aid?
What is that?
If water is that color, then I'm losing my brain.
It's definitely a water pitcher with something in it. That is true.
Yes, yes.
You're losing your brain.
We're not supposed to comment.
I think about the Mexican cheese in the door there.
I was thinking that. That's the one thing everybody's going to have in common.
I mean, in the perfect midnight session.
Just walk in, grab a handful. Like, I don't.
To be fair. All right,
panel, I've got to remind you that you're supposed to. We lost Mary Beth. She'll be back. She's charging her phone. Her phone died.
Yeah.
Good thinking.
So she will be back with us in a moment. But Mary Beth is, of course, one of your options for these refrigerators. Panel, you're not supposed to comment. We're supposed to look at it real quick. I'm going to give some play-by-play real fast. We're going to move on.
We're supposed to be quiet now.
You'll have your, your chance to comment in a minute.
Okay, so be quiet, Corey, is what I'm hearing.
Fridge number two.
Oh, fridge number two.
If you were looking for more items in a fridge, we've got some right here. My goodness, plenty of items. What is it? Of course, you're zooming in, looking. We've got, I cannot tell what some of these items are, but this is definitely a full refrigerator. And we've got a freezer view here. What are those cans?
There's a trigger can.
Fridge number two. Fridge.
Dunkin'
number
Donut.
Two. Going right now. So if you want to answer, you got time. Until we're done, we're going to show all five. All four refrigerators and one wild card item, and you will guess again. One panelist, we will not see the refrigerator here. So we look at refrigerator number two for a moment. Get it in, soak it in. Guess, try to figure out who's going to be. I don't know. I cannot tell at all. Fridge number two seems a little difficult. Seems a little difficult.
Well, they ain't hungry. I promise you that.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. This is going to make everybody hungry. I think that's watching. We're still awaiting the return.
Looks like I got some leftovers up in there. I need to go over there and get some damn leftovers.
Well, Mary Beth, hopefully, will rejoin us as we go to fridge number three. Here's what we're looking at for fridge number three. All right, we can see some stuff here. We've got that looks like Milo's. We got some Milo's sweet tea.
Mm-hmm. It's just so you know, it's cheaper to buy the tea and brew it and put it in a pitcher.
And we've got milk.
Milk's healthy.
Got milk.
Eggs for protein.
Egg carton is open. The egg carton is open. And there's another egg carton. So the egg goes in multiple places in this refrigerator. All right, this is fridge number three, y'all. This is fridge number three.
Kevin, I think you have to tell the people we're all talking smack to each other real hard right now.
Yeah, they're being distracted by our private chat right now. CJ is definitely the referee of our private chat.
Damn right I am.
CJ is the trivia host. CJ, I mean, like you know, you got to make sure it's fair. We want to have a fair, honest game.
Got to follow the rules, people. Stick about the rules.
This ain't numb.
All right, so we got fridge number three. Fridge three, of course. That means our final fridge is coming up. Whose fridge is it anyway? That is the name of the game. We will have a fifth item. Remember, of our five panelists tonight, Mary Beth rejoining us momentarily. I hope. Does she need a full – what we need to be – there she goes. We've got an update. One is charging slower than Nevada is counting the votes is what we're getting.
I didn't know Mary Beth got jokes. I was not aware.
All right, here we go. Fridge number four. My goodness, some Coca-Cola classic. that also looks like some sweet tea. Is that Milo's? I don't know. All right, now what's in the door? Now these are some the door. It's like a higher end refrigerator, possibly. We've got the clear shelves on the door. Maybe not higher end. Maybe just newer refrigerator. Number four here. Whose fridge is it anyway? A Monster Energy drink. I can see at the top. I can see a Monster Energy drink here at the top of the refrigerator. Oh. I don't know if that's going to change the game here. And there's definitely some produce. This is the opposite of fridge number one in the bottom two shelves. All right, so this is fridge number four, folks. Five panelists, only four of them are refrigerator. Any panelist could be what we're going to see here in our fifth item, which is the wild card item, which are also, you're wagering all of these. Remember, if you're wagering 4 points, if you're wagering 4 points, you will lose 4 points if you miss that question. And if you get it correct, you'll get the 4 points. Same with whatever, any of the wager that you're doing. So there's a chance you can get negative. So keep that in mind as you wager. All right, we've got fridge number four. So that means our item is coming up. Our item is coming up next, which is, all right, this is exciting. Whose item is it? But first, let me tell you, this portion of the show is being brought to you by the patrons of Cerrito Entertainment. Go to patreon.com/Cerrito. Become a patron today. Big thanks to everybody who is a patron. We started our Patreon page here during the pandemic. It's a way for you not only to support what we do, but be entertained and have extra bonus games to play during these nights where you are stuck at home. So go to patreon.com/Cerrito. Become a patron today. Or you go to CerritoEntertainment.com and click on the Become a Patron button. We've got Patreon for our special patron only month. Every month we do a virtual bingo for our patrons, and we also have coming up an office trivia for the patrons, and there's Cerrito Trivia, the home game as well. Mary Beth's phone is still charging, it looks like, but hopefully we'll get her back in here for the reveal. All right, the final item again, it could be anybody. This item could be anybody on the panel. Zanaya, they've been told to take a picture of an item at their home and submit it. So who on the panel could this possibly belong to?
Hey, Kevin.
Yes.
I know we're not supposed to talk, but I don't see Michael Jackson on here. That's the lamp from Smooth Criminal, dog. Look at the lean. Put a hat on it. Look at the lean.
I mean, that thing is, wow. I've never seen its equal.
Lampy, are you okay? Are you okay? Are you okay?
CJ, break. I just was complimenting CJ on his strict rules and compliance.
Uh-huh, CJ.
Wow, poor Logan. His parents have neglected the property.
Also, we're supposed to be quiet, but all of us are being loud in ways that are so misleading.
I mean, I'd be proud to have that as a Halloween decoration. Just
as a Halloween decoration?
Is that what you think that is here?
That looks like some old.
Oh yeah,
looks like some old people haunted shit. Is what I'm hearing. Yeah, definitely. Also, Logan, now I see like some 30-year-old woman hitting on you, and you're like, "Damn, girl, you fine? You haunted? You so old? You must got ghosts."
What?
This is getting out of hand.
Hey, you want to be my boo?
Katrina is.
I'm sorry.
You've been off the stage for too long. This is your stage. I give you the opportunity to perform. That's fantastic.
I'm acting up and I'm showing my ass in front of company, like a whole Southern.
We're gonna have to lock the answers in.
Thanksgiving.
What?
That's why we invite you to Thanksgiving.
When I come into Thanksgiving, I just lead with my ass. I just march in.
Does anybody have an update on Mary Beth Conley? We are locking your answers in, so you need to get them in. We have 60 seconds. 60 seconds. We will be the last chance to submit your answers. If you're filling out the form, you have about 60 seconds to fill out your form. We'll give you a little bit longer in case folks are having some issues coming in. If you want to submit your answers, CerritoEntertainment.com.
Also, hi, Tom.
You have to go to the website. Go to the website.
Go to the website. It's one form. You fill it out. Put your team name at the top. We'll give it another. We'll give it another second here, because I know you.
God, if you don't hurry up, I'm gonna get lung cancer tonight.
How many cigarettes is that?
Four, five. I don't know.
Okay, this portion of the show is being brought to you by Cash Saver. As I mentioned at the top of the program, Cash Saver is sponsoring our grand prize this month. We're giving away a Thanksgiving dinner for four if you win best team name or first place overall tonight. You will be entered in the drawing after three. We've got 3 weeks, of this program scheduled. Whose Fridge Is It Anyway? Here in November, we'll be back next week with an all new panel sharing their refrigerator. And unless some of y'all got multiples, I don't know. I bet Logan does. The
you know what?
Was that the sixth burn or no?
That's just a guess. I'm just guessing, like everybody else is on these refrigerators.
Damn, boy, you got three fridges though.
The form link, you can find the form link easily in the Facebook chat. But I know folks are watching on all types of different streaming outlets tonight. So if you're still looking for that, we're giving you a little bit extra time tonight. It could be some technical difficulties like Mary Beth had. Anyway, Cash Saver, there's three Memphis area locations, and they'll do delivery if you live within 6 miles, courtesy of DoorDash. And they'll know Cash Savers know the owners and operators of what's that place called? Oh, High Point Grocery. Yes, High Point Grocery. So go check out their new better prices and better beer selection there at the High Point Grocery. Prices are so low now. All right.
Hey, Cash Kevin, real quick, I just want everybody to know Cash is worth going out of your way to get a Cash Saver hot plate. The breakfast plate is wonderful.
Man, what
that you chicken said? Is so good. Oh my gosh. The hot and they do it by the pound. Breakfast they do by the pound. You get all of the breakfast food for like $6. It's great.
The best thing about a by the pound places are where you have to be savvy. You have to know you cannot load up on the wrong thing.
You can mess around with like nine pieces of bacon for 50 cents.
Don't be silly and get the chicken, get the bacon.
Oh, tell them.
Oh my God. Why am I hungry right now?
Man, I'm ready for some sauce and gravy.
All right. Mary Beth rejoins us.
Hey, Mary Beth.
Hello.
Hey, I'm back. You know, and I can't. Hey. Okay, so here's the deal. I am listening to you on the computer, listening to you on the phone, but I can see on the computer. I am totally technologically tonight.
No, but the
I don't know what I'm doing.
You're getting there because you are adapting and overcoming like all 25-year-olds are capable of doing. And we're great
That's
at that.
Right. That's right. I'm also going to be drinking here shortly. So,
turn up.
Just because all the adapting is making me crazy.
All right, you start drinking, and I'm going to start a private chat, and we're going to talk about what it's like to be on the news in Memphis.
All right, I don't know what we got to do. All right,
somebody has to, Kevin.
We're locking the answers in for the teams. We're locking the answers in for the team. So we're cutting it off now. We're going to shut the form down. And we're going to go through and reveal some answers.
Corey
with his signs.
Oh, man. troll face Corey.
Corey, we can listen to you now on 98.1 The Max. How did you make that jump? So you are Country Corey on 98.1 The Max.
I'm Country Corey every day. That's who I am.
kids, cigarettes, hollering, yelling.
It doesn't matter what radio station I'm on. I'm still the same dude. You know what I mean? So, yeah, afternoons on 98.1 The Max, we're having some fun.
Raise hell, praise Dale.
Look, we honor a redneck hero every day at 5:20.
Which one?
Who was today's redneck hero?
Today's redneck hero was old boy's stepdad. They were clearing out the ditch, and the old truck they were in, he was supposed to get it for his graduation present. And it went into the spillway on the passenger side, and his stepdad cut his seatbelt and threw him out the sunroof with one hand. And he and then they fixed the truck and still gave it to him for graduation.
Nice.
Any male can be a father, but it takes a real man to be a stepdaddy. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you, my dear. You're exactly right. And I just want to let you know that I appreciate your point of view on that.
I told you I grew up in West Memphis. I try to keep my accent low, but you're triggering me real hard right now, damn it.
Well, don't come over here, because even CJ talks like this when he comes over here.
Hey, I don't know if I can talk like that if I try.
Let's reveal some answers. Let's reveal some answers here.
Give me the lamp.
I need to know who's got that lamp, because, you know.
We got
the Mexican cheese.
Come look at fridge number one.
Can we go in now? Can we talk about this?
Fridge number one. If this is your fridge, reveal whose fridge is this anyway. Whose fridge is it?
Who's that bachelor?
It's mine. It's my fridge.
What did I do?
It's CJ's fridge.
Listen, don't judge me. Listen, we grocery shop every Friday or Saturday before college football, and we only buy enough for the week. So it's at the end of the week, all the food is gone because we ate it. That's how we roll.
What is in that water filter pitcher?
So it is water.
You got jalapenos or kimchi? What is that with the red top?
Where? That is strawberry jelly.
Strawberry. So you got jelly cheese, goat's milk, and whatever the hell that is with the blue.
CJ.
The blue.
Yes, man.
CJ, tell the truth. Did you get the Lysol out and clean that fridge before you took that picture today? Because that is a clean refrigerator for a bachelor.
No, I did not. I cleaned it a month ago, though. So I'm like, oh, I'm glad Kevin asked. Now, last month it would have been terrible.
I call BS on that. I have three sons your age. No. No, 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 no.
Mary Beth, I got a wife who I live with. She's not going for a dirty fridge. Oh. She's like, hey, you need to clean that.
Oh, I thought it's you said you were I thought you said you were single. Okay.
I said it looked like a bachelor fridge, but he let me know they were fresh shopping every week, which looks like a bachelor fridge. Also, CJ, I would like for you to post on social media how clean your fridge is on Saturday because of how pissed off your wife is going to be about you hollering and yelling on Thursday night.
She is so mad at me right now.
You better clean that fridge.
She is not happy.
All right, we're on to fridge number two. So CJ was fridge one. Fridge number two, this one's jam-packed to the rafters here. These items are not practicing social distancing. All right, whose fridge is it anyway?
Not it.
Whose fridge is it anyway?
It's Logan's.
You got to say if it's yours, buddy.
Oh, I'm not supposed to say it?
No, say if it's yours.
Oh, it's mine. Yeah, it's mine.
Yeah,
it's mine.
Guilty. It's Corey's fridge.
It's my fridge. Yeah, it's mine.
You got food flowing out. Corey's making it rain frozen food. I see you.
Also, them eggs. So
it's
many
really
eggs.
Not very big. Yeah, most of that is meat that I intend on grilling or making soup, or Margot intends on doing something with. I mean, we have a meal plan, and everything in that, except for the beer, goes for the meal plan. It's very calculated by my wife, not me.
What gives it away is the 2 18 packs of eggs. Because if you're cooking for five kids, you and your wife, you cannot make breakfast without 20 eggs.
Yeah. I got five kids in all. I only got two at home. the youngest two. And they're 19 and 13. The others are grown and they got to buy their own damn groceries.
That's got me.
I mean, fridge two was Country Corey's fridge.
It was mine.
Very tight.
I think stuff. Fridge number three is next. Fridge three. We'll take another look at this one. The Milo sweet tea. This is the.
Yeah. That gives it away.
All right. Who does it? Whose fridge is it anyway?
It's my fridge. And no, the Milo sweet tea. My fiance drinks that when he's in town. That thing's been there like a month. It's got too much sugar for me. Why you should know this is mine is because of all the Tupperware. Okay, not Tupperware because that's too expensive. The fake Rubber Tupperware. The old cool containers with leftovers.
Yeah.
Family of seven kids, baby. We save it if it's like this much food. We'll save it. Because you never know where your next meal's.
Mm-hmm. Also got two packs of eggs. Just let it be known. Also got two packs of eggs.
Right.
Yeah. And the little V8, the little can of V8.
Yep, that's nutritious and healthy. Yeah. I got a lot of vegetables too, but I didn't show my vegetable drawer because it's
Katrina.
You got fiancés in different area codes.
I have
area codes.
What?
So you said when your fiance
it's better than that. And my fiance is my eighth grade crush.
Nice.
Wow.
But is there a possibility that there's three different dudes who think that they're this dude right now?
Oh. Well, maybe they are. No, I tell people we courted 46 in 10 days. But he likes Milo, so. That's why we got that.
That's dope.
Fine.
So far we've got CJ, Corey, Mary Beth, Conley. The bottom row in that order so far. Got to get out of the order now. We're down to the final fridge. Fridge number four. Is it going to be Katrina's fridge or is this Chef Logan's refrigerator? Whose fridge is it anyway?
My fridge,
Logan.
Yeah,
not enough pickles for me. I don't see.
The thing about that fridge that's a dead giveaway is you got those preserved lemons in the drawer at the top upper corner there.
No, the rice vinegar gave it away.
Yeah, the rice wine vinegar, the rose water,
vinegar gave it away.
The leftover Popeyes in there.
The sugar free monster was a false flag because that totally.
Yeah, that I was trying to throw you off with that one.
It is out of place.
Yeah. Rose water, Logan. What do you do with rose water? I thought that was something you bathe in.
No. Yeah, I make I actually made a rose water salmon one time, and it was pretty good.
Of course you did. God.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
Dude, I'm what are you talking about? I make that twice a week. Rose water salmon. you're half-assing it, kiddo.
Ever since Taco Bell dropped the whatever the pizza was.
Oh, yeah.
So you started making rose water salmon. Because your gourmet Taco Bell pizza is off the menu.
That was before. That's not now.
Also, for the record, Taco Bell Mexican pizza is just a real, real fat tostada.
It's a double-decker tostada with beans and meat. Oh, it's delicious.
I did the same thing tonight. I was like, do I get a Taco Bell Mexican pizza or do I make rosewater salmon? I just can't decide.
So you ended up with a Mexican salmon pizza.
with a rosewater dressing.
Right, with a rosewater drizzle.
Let's get to our final item. It was the wild card item. So we had four refrigerators, no refrigerator from Katrina, but this one could be anybody on the panel. You know, it's not defaulting to being Katrina. Anybody on the panel, this is their.
Everyone was very disrespectful about this lamp.
Man, I wish I had this lamp. I mean, it's so artistic, you know.
It's crap.
Who's ever lamp that is, throw a white jacket and a white hat on it tomorrow. You just have to.
It's my lamp. It's my lamp.
Whose lamp is it anyway? It is Corey's.
It's mine. I love lamp.
You love your
it takes just one bag of Crete in like a half hour. But in the 2 years that I've lived here, I just can't do it. I'm just too lazy, a homeowner. And it just sits there all crooked for the neighbors to judge me.
To be fair, like, your lamp looks
just like everybody has tonight.
Your lamp looks like it's had about 6 Coors Lights and 12 cigarettes. So that should have been the hit. Should have been the giveaway.
Thanks.
I'm teasing.
I feel so loved by people I barely know, except for
Lamp. Lamp looks like it's going to do a walk of shame.
Jay, you can put that lamp in person. So
that lamp has its shoes like. In these two fingers.
It kind of does.
Poor lamp.
That lamp's going, are you Jeremy?
Hey, let us know in the comments. Let us know in the chat how many you got correct. We are scoring your answers to find out who our winning team is. But let us know. We want to know, like, how many did you get correct? How many did you get correct? Let us know in the chat, in the comments. If you got them all, I'd be surprised tonight. The leaning poll, not sure where it would have gone there. All right, so panel, we're also going to vote for best team name tonight. Y'all are going to vote for best team name tonight. Of course, teams have been, they submitted their answers. We have Patrick coming in, and he got none correct. First one to jump in. To let us know. Maybe a chance for best team name. Maybe it'll be a bunch of negative scores going up.
I do appreciate anyone that voted that any of these fridges were mine, because you guys all have fridges I would love to get into. And that sounds way dirtier than I meant for it to, but I'm just trying to be nice.
We're getting lots of zeros coming in.
Oh, man.
Let me get in that fridge stuff.
But, man, I thought mine was a giveaway.
I love that fridge.
You packed it with all the sodas. You threw them off because you had all those sodas.
But I like a lot of sodas. I mean, just
so. But obviously, you do.
Yeah,
I mean, too. I drink soda during the day.
Oh yeah.
What do you think?
One for breakfast, one for lunch, and then one for gaming with my Call of Duty.
We were surprised. If they would have been Mountain Dews, I think everybody would have called.
Oh yeah.
Everybody would have called you if they'd been Mountain Dews, but
yeah.
Lots of negative points. All good. All right, so we're going to vote for best team name. I'm going to give you the options. Panelists, I will go to you each one at a time, and you will reveal your vote, just like a reality show, Logan, of who you're voting for. You can write it down, or you can just say it, however you want to do it. Your pick for best team name tonight. Let's see what our choices are. These are the teams submitting their answers. We have the Clark Crew. Who the hell drank my apple juice? My teammate is my dog's grandmother. Memphis Fridge Raiders, and waiting on your answers, just like Nevada. So your team names again tonight: the Clark Crew, who the hell drank my apple juice, my teammate is my dog's grandmother, Memphis Fridge Raiders, and waiting on your answers, just like Nevada. So those are the teams that submitted their team answers tonight. The winner of best team name will get automatically entered in our drawing for Thanksgiving dinner for four. All the supplies you need to cook that Thanksgiving dinner. And Logan will come over to your house. He will prepare it for you.
No, he's already coming to my house. He's rooking for
it. I got my green eggs. So I'm doing the green egg turkey this year, and it's going to be real.
It's really? My house. And you're not invited.
I thought it was green eggs and ham.
Any Thanksgiving tips, Logan?
Don't you know the green egg barbecue grill?
You know, the little green egg. Yeah,
the big one.
Yeah.
You cook the turkey and it comes out amazing.
I told you, I grew up in West Memphis. We grill on a fire pit we made out of
the fire pit. I mean.
Okay. Does anybody need me to repeat the names? You need to. You will be voted. Does anybody need me to repeat any of the names?
No.
All right. Let's go to the votes here. Let's go to some votes.
All
right. Logan, we'll start with you. What is your vote for best team name?
Oh, man. Who the hell drank my apple juice?
Apple juice.
Apple juice.
Getting a vote. Apple juice. Katrina, who you got? Best team name.
There are two that are really good, but I have to agree, as a mother, who the hell drank my apple juice?
All right. Apple juice. Receiving two votes already. CJ?
Man, it reminds me, this team name reminds me of Barbershop when Eve goes to the fridge and comes out and has this half-drunk bottle of apple juice. Who drank my damn apple juice? I'm rolling with the apple juice one, too.
Apple juice team name.
We still love the topical name.
But no way it can lose here. No way it can lose. There's not. There's no other path to victory here on the map.
Apple juice.
You want apple juice to make it?
I was going to vote for it before. Before you remind me of Barbershop. Who the hell drank my apple juice?
She was hot, boy. She was somebody for
that. Man, what was out for blood?
Somebody's going to catch them hands over that apple juice, boy.
Yeah, man. Apple juice is $1.50. And I bought that shit specifically for my blood sugar.
I personally kicked three doors open. Screaming that same thing.
No, I'm sorry. I'm going to be Georgia and Arizona, because apple juice gives me gas. So I'm voting for. So I'm going to do what nobody else is ever going to do, like Georgia and Arizona. I'm going to have to vote for the waiting for your vote, waiting for your number. What was it? Waiting for your answers, like Nevada.
Waiting for your vote. Yeah.
Hopefully, we've given everybody a decent escape tonight. Katrina, though, is our election correspondent. Nothing's happening. Nothing has happened while we've been on.
No, I haven't checked. Actually, my therapist has told me I'm not allowed to check more than once an hour because my blood pressure is through the roof.
You should get a job.
I do have a job. Also, I have a lot of Buprenorphine, but not enough, apparently. Right. So. We're all feeling it. My election correspondence is to enjoy your night very quietly and pretend like it's fine.
Are we still? We're going to announce the winner here in a moment.
Way down deep.
Of trivia. We're calculating the scores, all your wagers, but let me tell you about what's coming up here with Serrita Entertainment. Every Saturday night, we're at the Summer Drive-In through Thanksgiving weekend. This weekend's Harry Potter movie trivia, so come play with us, all thanks to our sponsor, Cash Saver. It's socially distanced trivia, and it is free with a paid admission to the drive-in. So you can check out their schedule and buy your tickets at malco.com. What is
Cash Saver?
All right. Yes, that's...
Y'all remember that?
Wait, you will literally shut this thing down to read anything I put up on here.
I will read whatever you put up there. You know that. This Corey brings the paper, doesn't need it. So that's happening tomorrow. Also coming up, it's coming Saturday. It's only Thursday. This week, I'm telling you, all the days are blending together. We're back with live trivia on Wednesday nights at Rec Room. They have a brand new patio. We're playing trivia outside on their front lawn. They've got fire pits, and trivia is free. We play at 7 o'clock. Through the month of November on Wednesday nights. We're back at bars, at least here for a few weeks. Space out, mask required, and play some trivia, win some prizes, cook some s'mores on those fire pits there at Rec Room. They are
Cerrito trivia and fire. Can't be a better combination.
Is that the best combo possible? Also on Wednesday nights, we've got a new show, Hopular Mechanics. I host this with Taylor James from the Madison Growler Shop, which is inside of Cash Saver. We talk beer. Where's my can? I got my can from last night over here. We had BrewDog's Nitro, one of the Nitro beer here. It's a wrestling themed beer. We had that talked about it last night, but you can tune in live for our live stream on Wednesday nights, talking beer. And of course, we'll be back here next week. What will we be drinking here next week, Katrina?
Whatever we want to.
But what else are we going to drink?
Riverside Rye. Great sipper. Goes down smooth, but 93 proof? Is that right?
You've had it. You know all about it.
Katrina has wrestling figures on the back of her shiffer robe back there. Cabinet or whatever the hell you call it.
It is an entire China cabinet.
On the top of the cabinet, man. Those are WWF figures, are they not?
Some of them are WWE. Look, we're gonna have to do a private thing later.
Okay. I didn't mean to call you out.
It's not negative. There are lots. Y'all want to talk about wrestling? Are we gonna do a Twitch about wrestling after this?
Burrito, can we talk about wrestling?
We can, absolutely.
Can we just keep this thing going
right now?
Go against the current and grab a bottle of Riverset Rye today. It's crafted right here in Memphis. Pick up a bottle today. You want to do to have a? We can do a wrestling live stream at any point, Katrina. Anytime you want to do that.
Y'all want to do it right now? I mean, it's only 9:48. Corey's got me. Country is all get out right now. I cannot get this out of
Let's talk about wrestling. Let's talk about wrestling.
I mean, we can. My oldest baby daddy is a wrestler.
Let's find out.
End this shit and we'll text each other later.
This is getting out of hand.
As we are.
We'll be back drinking Riverset, peeking into your refrigerators next week because we all know what's inside of everybody's liquor cabinet. It should be Riverset. Right. Okay, the winner. We got to announce the winner. But before we do that, what's coming up with you guys? What's going on, Logan? What's coming up with you?
You know, reapplying to college and just kind of working through some stuff, trying to work out a new cookbook maybe, thinking about it, trying to write some recipes. You know, I've been doing some really cool stuff with these chicken chips. So these chips that are made out of, like, chicken, and they taste really amazing. The buffalo flavor's the best, and they're just...
Well, you've got them real thin?
Hold on.
Yeah, they're pretty cool. They're like chicken chips. So like chicken breast turned into potato chip.
Oh, so you do cut them real thin.
Oh yeah. They're like a product. You buy them in a bag.
Okay.
Yeah, they're pretty good.
Okay.
So, you know,
I'm looking for that.
You know, I've been doing stuff with them. Got some more stuff coming around. You know, I'm getting ready to do my turkey on Thanksgiving. I do a special cry and I'm cooking it on the green egg. You know, just kind of gearing up for stuff. Kind of keeping it very chill, trying not to get sick, staying safe, you know what I mean.
All right. And folks can follow you. Where's the best way to keep up with what you're doing?
Just follow me on Instagram at Logan Junior Chef, Facebook, Twitter, all that. And that's the place.
Hey, Katrina, what do you have going on besides being the best dressed member of the panel with that Virtual Memphis Beer Fest t-shirt on?
There we go. Okay. Well, showing my boobies on the internet for way
you need an OnlyFans.
No, I don't. Work with Kevin, I will not be making quite a luxurious. I'm very curious about these chicken chips. I'm going to dip them in ranch and or sauce. Super excited about that. Just trying to figure everything out. Still standing. Funniest comic in Memphis based on the Memphis Flyer. And you can follow me on Katrina O. Coleman everywhere you have social media.
All right. And CJ, you're getting up early tomorrow.
I'm going to check in with Tommy Jacks at 11 tonight.
Yeah. Are you going to be on Tommy Jacks show? He's in the chat.
If I can have enough of this whiskey to forget that I have to work tomorrow, I'll be there.
CJ. You are up early. You're rising and grinding the new show with the Memphis Grizzlies, right?
With Grind City Media. Yep. You guys check the show out every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, 8 o'clock till we feel like stop talking, basically. So about 8 till 9:30, 9:45, who knows? Follow me on Twitter at Conradicalness. I'm on the Instagram too, at new_conradicalness. Because
did you forget your password, Papa?
Yep. Absolutely forgot the password and can't get into Conradicalness.
Old ass.
And then we've got...
Hey, I'm 25 like the rest of us.
We're 26, so we're more mature than you.
Country Corey.
That's why I make all my passwords the same.
How much money, Corey, did y'all raise for the Ronald McDonald House last week?
$500,000.
$500,000. Oh, wow.
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
It's crazy.
A pandemic.
And during a pandemic. That's exactly right. But Man, people are generous. And when you ask them to give for kids that need to be close to the care they need with the family they love, man, people come out for that. And you can't blame them for it. You know what I mean? So, heck yeah, that was the bomb.
And so you're on what time to what time now on 98
3,
won the match?
3 to 7, 98 won the match. We do the Redneck Hero at 5:20 every day. And we'd love to hear your stories about some crazy redneck that did some awesome stuff.
I gotta get out of my habit of turning on Kix 106 immediately when I'm in the car. I'll just jump back and forth. 98 won the max now to listen to.
Well, I wouldn't want to tax you too much, Kevin.
Well, Jarman used to be on. Was Jarman on in the afternoon? Because I was listening to flipping between you and Jarman anyway. I think we've got.
Well, Jarman is still on in the afternoon, so it's everybody does everything.
Wait, Jarman's in the morning now, right?
Yeah, they do the morning show. Danny and Jarman do the morning show, and then I'm on the afternoon, and we play rock and roll, baby.
Yeah.
The max. Man. Mary Beth Conley, live at 9. Y'all got brand new studios. Are you going in every day?
Yep. Yep. I am the one of the few who's been going in every day since day one. Everybody else was live via Zoom, but I did live at 9 in person. So, because I'm tough. But I'm getting ready to start two new media projects. One is a talk show, and the other is a very cool project to help inmates who have served their time returning to the community. We're going to build them some houses. So it's all going to be documented.
Y'all working with
so Justin. That's not going to be like immediate, but we're in talks is all I'm going to say. So I'm excited.
Yeah, and I'm looking forward to your talk show. I do miss listening to you on that station that we will not name.
Right. Yeah, had to leave those guys. That was a bad scene. The George Floyd killing. They were just out and out on social media, and I just wasn't going to be a part of it. So, sorry. So, K-Wham. Goodbye. So, anyway.
You name them.
Hey. They apparently had no problem with their stance on social media. So truth is truth.
Everybody will show their true colors. That's the damn truth.
This is really good info, but her phone is messing up. I'm sure this is great
stuff. I really wish we could hear what that was, what she said there.
What, is my phone freezing?
Yeah, your phone. Yeah, we didn't miss it. Say, repeat it again. We'd love to hear it here.
What part did you miss?
After
the whole damn thing.
Not the whole thing, but like, this the part. I know you're.
Yeah, the last 10 seconds or so.
After Corey said true colors.
Oh, yeah. I just said, it was new ownership at K-Wham. It was not the old, K-Wham back in the day was awesome. But in April, it got bought by someone who, in my opinion, is a little, shall we say, right of center, as in like far right. And unfortunately...
Your show's gone, but you're still doing live at 9. You're bringing your show back live at 9. Of course, WREG. I love the new set. Looks awesome on TV. I can't wait to someday get back in there and see it. Is there a couch and stuff for live at 9? Oh no! Now we've lost audio from Mary Beth. I appreciate all of y'all being here today. Everybody who tuned in for our pilot episode of this is. I appreciate it. We will be playing again next week. I can confirm on next week's panel. We do have Muck Sticky. Muck Sticky will be here.
Wait, Kevin, will it be less messy? Will it be less messy next week's show?
What do you mean?
Keep the same messy.
Will it be less messy? Because if it is less messy, I don't like it.
No, it will be. It's going to be a train wreck every week. And they're better that way. Like, Kevin has totally lost control of this whole thing.
All right. I'm wrapping it up right now. We're going to announce the winner.
Sorry.
Again, thanks to all y'all for playing along. Thanks to the panel for being here. I really appreciate it. It's Logan's ready to go play some video games. The winner tonight. How about this? They are double winners. Who the hell drank my apple juice? Ended up with 12 points. I don't know how they did it.
Oh, man.
That's three.
But who the hell drank my apple juice? Best team name and first overall. They're going to have two entries in our contest to win that Thanksgiving.
They're not getting negative points.
Was I on that team? Did someone cheat?
Most teams ended up with negative points with these.
Oh, man.
But
money.
Not Team Apple Juice. So congratulations there. Panel, thanks for giving us a peek inside your lives. And yeah, we're out of here. We'll be back next week for another edition of Whose Refrigerator Is It Anyway? Enjoy the rest of your night, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your election. Enjoy the rest of your election. It continues.
Follow lawsuit to keep this thing going.
Wrestling talk later.